Sorry, Jake, what's your idea?
Look, okay, take it like this, so we do this.
Okay, so how we will measure if the walls are straight at Pennington is, first we will set up the string to the wall and then to the floor at an angle, and then we'll measure from the top of the string to the ground along the wall, then we'll measure from the top of the string to the bottom of the string, and then we'll measure the ground from the string to the wall. And then once we get all the measurements, we will multiply them by, we'll do the theory.
Is the hypotenuse, and this is going to be the measurement for a squared, and we're going to put this up here and then put the string down there.
So if Patrick makes a perfect angle by where Patrick's foot is, so we use the string as a hypotenuse, the ruler will go up against the wall so we know how high we're going, and we will measure the floor and we'll see what this is. So
measure the string and then place the ruler against the wall, and then we will put the string from the top of the ruler and bring it to the ground to find out each size length.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna tie this string to the top of a wall, and then we're gonna put it on the ground. Someone's gonna step on the string, and then we're gonna measure what C is, which will be the string, and then the diagonal will be C. And then this part down here, the bottom one, will be B, and that part will be A. And then we need to figure out C squared equals A squared plus B squared.
Were not straight because when we used the theory and multiplied, we squared A and B and compared it to the hypotenuse, they weren't the same. I stretch my hands out to the sky. We
dance with monsters through the night. Whoa, oh, oh, oh. None of our measurements were straight. None of the walls were straight, and probably because we had measurement errors.
Yeah, the outside of the gym, since there wasn't right anymore. That was awesome.